Adam's apple, specializing in peeling onions.
You know, if the transmission's got an Adam's apple.
Good morning. It's me, Mikey Pipes, and Air Force Nun. One of little words this morning. It's early. Today is Wednesday, June 15th, 2022. Heading over to Atlantic Beach. Client's got a Munchkin boiler with problems. Let's go see what's going on. The only effing toll on Long Island. The only toll. A toll to go over a bridge. Insane. When I mean Long Island, I mean Nassau and Suffolk County. So heading over to Long Beach, nice beautiful day. We're going to an oceanfront property. Let's see what's going on with this Munchkin after we pay the piper, pay the man. No easy pass accepted, by the way. No easy pass.
Got a nice view, Chris. Nice view of the ocean. All right, let's go check out this Munchkin.
There she is, little baby boiler. It's a Munchkin. Like, it's kind of like a Dunkin' Donuts Munchkin. I wonder if they paid royalty to Dunkin' Donuts IP holder.
Doubt it.
I doubt it too. So we have an error. We have an F13 error. That has something to do with motor, blower motor, I think. Take a look at the install. We'll have to see the vent piping outside, but looks like mulch. Where's all this mulch coming from? What's going on here? We have this multi-million dollar townhouse on the ocean. We have, looks like mulch, black mulch. Interesting. All right, Chris, let's get the tool back. All right, I got the cover removed. This thing's in pretty bad shape. And there's our blower motor with the gas valve attached to it. Looks like a little pressure switch. It's condensing, huh? Yep. You can tell that by the PVC vent piping. We have the right relief valve on there. That's a good thing. There's our control module. It's in pretty bad shape. It is in pretty bad shape. We have an electric water heater. It looks like a storage tank piped off of it. As an indirect. Wow, it's split too. Okay. So we have a zone off the boiler acting as an indirect. And we have also tied in this electric water heater with directions if there's problems. No, second system. Well, F13 is blower speed issue. So let's power cycle it and see what it does. I wonder, where's our temperature and pressure gauge? Do you see one, Chris? I don't see a temperature and pressure gauge. Oh, look, they got the Moen flow. We put one in a couple weeks ago. I don't see a temperature and pressure gauge anywhere here. So let's see, boiler feed valve is right there. That's on, good. Let's just make sure we got water in there. Okay, let's see what happens. It immediately goes to error F13. That's a fault. So let's see if I can reset it. Okay. Don't sound too healthy. Oh, ramping up. We have ignition. It's heating up relatively quickly too, no less. Look at that. Small little baby boiler. Oh. Ramping down in speed. Our temperature is slowly dropping. Went to a high as 113. You know, I smell some gas. Yeah, I smell some gas. Yeah. Chris, you want to get the soapy water? You know, it's used by plumbers for centuries to find leaks. Hmm. We're at 119 now, 120. Not looking too healthy, this machine. It'd probably be best suited replacing this. We have a 2-inch gas line coming in. Nope, sorry, 1.5 inches. 1.5 inches. 3/4. Yeah, let's see what the soapy water tells us. All right, before we use our soapy water, someone got us for our soapy water, huh? Well, we got this from Platsky when we went on that Bosch IDS training one morning. But before we start spraying this down, I do smell gas, and that's a concern, but let's make sure we have the proper voltages. Let's turn this off, all right? And let's just make sure our connections are solid going into this thing, these Molex connectors. Okay, so here is power, which will be AC voltage, and I don't see any corrosion on the Molex connector. All right, so let's check, make sure we have a minimum of 108 to a maximum of 132 volts between the black and the white. And if we have it outside that range, we're gonna have to have an electrician figure out the power problem. So let's check voltage there first. And power is off. You got the voltmeter set up. Let's go to the red and the white. We got our fluke stain. So that works too.
Where are we going?
Black and white. Black and white. In there. All right. Let's turn the power on. And we have 124 volts there. So that is good. Okay, next. Let's plug this back in. Let's see, I'm blind. All right, next we want to measure DC voltage for fan speed control. Now, we're going to set our voltmeter to DC voltage, okay? And we're going to take the red lead and put that on the red wire and the black on the blue. All right, so we have red on red, black on blue. our meter is set to read DC voltage, and let's turn on power. We're looking between 24 and 40, and we have 36. If you're not within that range, and if you're lower than 24 volts, according to HTP, Munchkin, you want to look for something that's drawing in the power, check other connections, and if all the connections look good, you want to replace this control. Now, if everything else checks out, then you're within that range. And this is where we just condemn the boiler. Because at this point, now we need a meter. A little bit of glare there. Now we need a meter that's going to read duty cycle. And this is according to folks at HTP. I've never even heard of that before. And I have multiple meters, right? Multiple high-end Fluke meters. I need to measure what?
Duty cycle. Which is, hold on.
What does that mean? What does that mean, Air Force None?
I thought maybe we could do duty cycle without.
Yeah.
Let's see here. Hold on.
Duty cycle. What is this duty cycle? I'll tell you what it does mean. It's time to replace this Munchkin.
Oh, now the connections.
Oh, it's because we're in a basement on the ocean. Oh!
Yeah.
Duty cycle is pulse width in seconds and hertz.
Times 100.
Oh, no.
We're not measuring that.
Oh, no.
Not with your Flukes. That's
for sure. We know we're better off going a give and go. Or come and go.
Jizz and jet.
All of my wiring, Molex connectors look fine. Essentially, if you have something that measures a duty cycle and it reaches 100%, then you're foobar.
That's according to HTP. And by the way, good luck getting them on the phone.
All right, so got a call back from HTP talking about this duty cycle. And he's like, yeah, don't worry about it. You know, but if you get your voltages are correct, you need a new fan assembly. The problem I have with just replacing the fan assembly is that sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. What happens if right now it's working, but at the end of the day, it's the control instead? So let's say, you know, customer spends $1,000 replacing the blower assembly, right? And then it comes back, and now we have to replace the control board. No bueno, huh? I don't like to pay twice. I did that when I fired my landscaper, and then rehired him because I tried to save a buck by not changing my car insurance to Geico. So my recommendation still stands. Our first recommendation is to, due to condition, age, the smell of gas inside of it, warrants replacement. And I recommended the Burnham Alta, right? Or the Bosch Green Star Wall Hung Combi. We'll see what they decide on. Thanks for tuning in. Be well, God bless, stay safe.